Hey GlamFam, Linwood here, and today I'm going to be talking to you guys about low porosity. Now, I did do a video on porosity before, but a lot of people asked if I could do individual videos on porosity based on low porosity, normal porosity, and high porosity. And so this is kind of the beginning of that series. Now, in this video, we'll be discussing low porosity primarily, but I will touch on some issues that pertain to porosity in general because that's kind of important. And we'll get down into the nitty gritty. Let's dive right in. So, porosity is defined as the ability to absorb and retain moisture, which means that it's your hair's ability to take in moisture, but to also hold it in place. Now, when you think about porosity, you want to think about absorbency. Think about something like a sponge. A sponge is very porous. It's able to take in a lot of moisture. Now, you also want to think about other surfaces, like let's say a metal table, something along those lines that really does not absorb moisture well. In that instance, you would have high porosity being the sponge, low porosity being the table, you catch the drift. When it comes down to dealing with porosity, you have to understand that this is going to impact a number of different things in the hair, and this is why it's important. This deals primarily with the cuticle layer of the hair. The cuticle layer of the hair is the outermost layer, and it is shaped like scales on a roof. Now, what that means is basically it's the cuticle layer's job to give shine to the hair. It's responsible for helping out with keeping the hair from getting tangled, as well as an abundance of other things. That hair opens and closes, that layer of the hair opens and closes, allowing things to easily get into the hair, and that is how it's impacted. Now, with higher porosity hair, the cuticles are naturally wider open, so things can more easily get in and escape. But with low porosity hair, the cuticles tend to be closed tighter, so we tend to need a bit more assistance to get moisture in. That being said, it's also much more difficult for moisture to get out, which is exactly why I have this steamer right here behind me. It is heating up, so if you guys see it start steaming, that's what the deal is. And I have this back here because primarily when you are dealing with low porosity hair, you want to keep in mind that that hair is going to need a different type of deep conditioning. Heat is almost always necessary when deep conditioning, but using steam can be a bit better because it does break the waters down to smaller molecular size, and it infuses a lot more moisture into the hair while you deep condition. So that's something that you definitely want to keep in mind as well. Now, this can be great also for dry scalps. It can be wonderful for processing color or just increasing your moisture balance in general. But I find that this is one of the best methods for low porosity hair to increase your moisture balance is by doing a standard deep conditioner with steam instead of doing it with a plastic cap method under dry heat. When you're dealing with low porosity hair, you want to keep in mind the moisture balance is significantly going to be higher just because it's harder for it to escape. So you'll find that you won't need to be deep conditioning incredibly frequently, but when you do, you'll really need some added assistance. Keep in mind that you can have multiple porosities in one head of hair, as well as on the same strand of hair. So typically you tend to have a lower porosity up towards the top, and as you travel down the shaft, naturally the porosity gets a bit higher. So hopefully you guys can see now the steam that's coming out of there. And of course you can adjust up here to where you get more steam inside, or vent it to get more steam outside based on your porosity level and how much moisture you need. These babies here are pretty inexpensive, and they also double as facial steamers with a different attachment. I really would recommend it if you have low porosity hair. Let me turn that off. Now, if you're looking into understanding a bit more about porosity, you have to understand, of course, the structure of the hair and what type of products you should be using as well. Usually, if you're low porosity, I would recommend going more on the side of liquid products because creams tend to sit on the surface of the hair and they don't absorb in well and they leave a bit of a film on the hair. So usually going for a liquid leave-in or a spray cream leave-in is gonna be a bit better than just using a straight up cream application leave-in. Same thing goes for your gels, your styling products, things like that. I almost always opt for a foaming wrap with a bit of setting lotion mixed in over using a gel or something along those lines if I'm looking to get some sort of hold to that hair. The reason why is because a lot of times gel doesn't tend to get along with it. But if you need the viscosity of the gel and you know that thickness that comes along with it, but you don't like the buildup factor, you can always take the products that you like and add a bit of water to them to water it down, and that way you get the desired intent out of that product as well. With low porosity, you'll find that it's not as prone to split ends as high porosity, but it is pretty prone to single strand knots, things like that. So a lot of times what I'll recommend on tons of my clients, especially if they have thick hair, is utilizing a wet brush or a Denman wet brush. It's just a brand, and its bristles are incredibly soft. The Denman paddle brushes are typically my recommendations as well. I recently purchased this one for the shop, which is why it's still in the box. And my Den Mint is at the shop and it's pretty beat up, so I wouldn't show it on camera right now anyway. But when you're dealing with that hair, using something like that can be fantastic for making sure you're not snagging through tangles, and then just plaiting it up prior to shampooing and conditioning. Now, I do hear a lot of people that say that with low porosity, that you need to use more aggressive shampoos, things like that. And honestly, that's really not that true. You don't need to use an aggressive shampoo for low porosity hair. Keep in mind that the lower your porosity level is, usually the healthier your hair is. So don't feel like you need to get to normal porosity. Your hair will naturally get there as it ages, and on the ends could even potentially get to high porosity on its own. So usually your best bet here is to treat the whole head like it's either normal or high porosity, because it's gonna be a bit better for you there in terms of styling. Also keep in mind that just because you're low porosity doesn't mean that you're significantly low. It could be your normal to low porosity. So you could see some different attributes that aren't quite there, or some different problems that don't really quite exist there as well. When you are wetting low porosity hair, you'll notice it seems like it takes a long time to get wet. It's almost like the water just kind of beads up off the hair and doesn't immediately absorb in. This is one of the indicators that your hair is low porosity. Now, if you're noticing that you're deep conditioning and then let's say the next day your hair feels like it's dried out all over again, things like that, that's usually a sign of high porosity. So if you're noticing that you have, let's say, the buildup from certain products, things like that, but that you're seeing where your hair is drying out really easily, there's a good chance you're not low porosity. Someone probably told you incorrectly, and you could just be using a product that doesn't agree with your hair well. So I hope that I've answered all those questions to your liking that you may have about low porosity hair. But if you have any further questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment box down below and let me know what specific questions you may have if you have normal porosity, high porosity, or aren't quite sure how to identify what your porosity level is. And I'd be more than happy to answer those as well. Until next time, you guys, take care, God bless, stay glam, and you know I love you, boo. Bye.